Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about science for preschoolers and my favorite resource to use for science. So, I have not really done too many, if any, preschool videos for this school year that we currently just started. I don't know why. I think I've just been so focused on my older daughter's stuff and making sure that they were good because my son's been good since day one. He uses the Good and the Beautiful curriculum. We're good. We got it because we kind of started preschool over summer. And so I kind of have just been like, oh, we've been doing that. No big deal. But I want to start sharing more preschool stuff with you guys. So if you want to see more preschool curriculum, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and leave that down below in the comments. So today's video is a preschool specific video. However, what I'm showing you guys could be used for, I would say, up to like a second grade level as well. Today's video is sponsored by Timberdoodle. Timberdoodle was nice enough to send me this book, which is amazing. It's an Usborne book, which I absolutely love. Usborne books, my very first science book, and this book is what we have been using for my preschoolers' science. But to be honest, I've never even really thought about science for a preschooler because we're just so focused on like letters and sounds and numbers. But as I've been doing science lessons with my older daughters, my preschooler is always like wanting to be involved. He was so cute. We were wrapping up our human body unit and he just sat in between them. And my daughters raise their hands when they need to ask questions when I'm reading aloud. And so he started doing that. And every time we would call on him, he would just start talking about skeletons. I don't know. It's not what we were talking about, but he really wants to be a part of those lessons. And so this book, my very first science book, which I will link down below, is our spine for his science. And now we're not using it in like the order. What I do is I normally will go through it and I will find the pages that correspond with maybe what topic I'm doing with my older daughters. And so this was his page that he got to do on the human body. And I think he really liked the skeleton one. And so that's why he keeps referring to it. But it's just in a very basic way for that little of a one to understand. It kind of breaks down the different body systems for him. And so I thought that this was really cute. We are about to do a fall unit study as well. So I've been planning for that. And so this one, we can talk about the different weathers and seasons, the different trees. We're actually taking a trip where we're actually going to see real fall leaves. We do not have fall leaves where we live. I just don't think we have those types of trees. Our trees just tend to look the same all the time. And they're not that pretty. So where we're going is it's going to be in fall and they're going to have the color changing trees. And so I'm really excited to kind of go through all of that with him. There's also just fun things that you can look through to find activities. So this one is floating and sinking. My three-year-old absolutely loves Blippi. I'm sure most toddlers do if they can watch that. And so Blippi always does it float or does it sink with toys? And so my son does that all the time in the bathtub. And so this we can actually talk through and he is really engaged because he understands it and he likes those types of activities. So this book is really awesome because it gives you just enough knowledge to read. It's very colorful. It has, you know, the fun little images, but it can be a little bit older of a kid too. So I would not shy away from this if you have like a pre-K, a kindergartner, even first grader, because it just has good general knowledge as well. There's all the different animals, like where all the different animals live, plants, and it has like all different things, like showing a plant grow and then what happens when the plant is done growing. Our world, different climates, it looks like, space, of course, all kids love space, the winters and seasons, what things are made out of. And so this would be a fun one. It has like fleece, plastic, concrete, so you could go on like a scavenger hunt around your house or on like a walk and find all of those things. It has like the kids dressing up, the flow or sink one, how things change. So mixing like sugar disappears in water. Again, that's like a really simple activity to just do like at your table. Oil and vinegar, water and cream. I know my three-year-old loves helping in the kitchen. Like he loves cracking eggs, he loves mixing. And so this talks kind of about melting chocolate, cookie dough, it's hot. So maybe some kitchen safety when it's light and dark. And so, you know, you can go outside when the moon's out, talk about the moon, the stars, there's light. And so, I don't know, this doesn't have page numbers, so I cannot tell you how many pages it is, but each of these pages, I would say, could be a lesson. And for a younger kid, a preschooler, this could be your entire science book for the school year. So I would pick a page and like the body one, like he could do this while we were doing our human body unit. And you could just go really slow. The skeleton, you could find a video to watch on the skeleton. You can find a coloring page to go along with it. And that's why I really love this book, as well as it's just the great Usborne quality. Like always, if you've ever used Usborne books, it's a really good quality book. So I will link this down below from Timberdoodle. If you're interested in learning more about Timberdoodle, they are a curriculum company that boxes up all these great curriculum choices like this science book into age-appropriate kits, and they have both religious and non-religious. So really they can meet anyone's needs, and they pick like the best curriculums, box it all together for you, and I think they even have like a schedule that tells you like what to do. So if you want even more information to make your life easier, we'll also link the PreK kit. So this book is part of their PreK kit, which I believe is a little bit higher level than what my son is at. And that's what I was saying. It could be used for younger levels, this book, or a little bit higher. So this is in their PreK kit. I'm gonna link that down below. Make sure you check it out because this book is super adorable if you have little ones that are interested in science. If you guys have more questions about this book or about Timberdoodle or about anything preschool, homeschool related, make sure you leave that down below in the comments. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I hope you all have a wonderful day. We will chat soon. Bye guys.